What's up, everybody, and welcome to another edition of AGR's Pop Culture Reviews. And I know, it's been about 2 weeks since I posted a video, and I'm very sorry, but life happens, guys, and I've been dealing with some next level shit, but I'm back on track, and I'm gonna get the reviews done. I got a ton of stuff to review, guys, and I mean a ton of stuff that I'm gonna try to get reviewed before Christmas break, so to speak, which include Robotech figures, the busts, I finally got them all in the studio, Hot Toys version of John Wick, the Concepts version of Wonder Woman, and a figure that is actually pretty cool of Captain Marvel. So guys, there is a lot of stuff that I gotta get through before the holidays begin, and we are going to do it. I'm gonna try to stay on task. Just be patient with me, guys. A lot of stuff going on. And you all know how wonderful the YouTube algorithm is, so if you don't watch the videos in a very long time, for some reason it doesn't send you those reminders to watch the videos. So make sure you hit the bell icon so you don't miss out on any of the new videos. Well, Lord knows that I've talked about this character a lot on the show, beginning with some of the lower end figures to the mid tier figures, and now we're going to be looking at a more high end figure and an offering by Hot Toys. So today we're going to be reviewing Hot Toys' version of Shuri, the 1/6 scale figure. Let's take a closer look. Guys, wow, just wow. The minute I took this thing out of the box, I instantly fell in love with it. That is absolutely Letitia Wright. This is an amazing representation of what we see in the film. Absolutely stunning head sculpt, guys. He is gorgeous. I love the skin tone here, especially the markings on her face and that stern look. Just look at her eyes, guys. How incredibly detailed. The sculpt on the hair is absolutely amazing. This thing is so beautiful, guys. As I always mention, there is just a level and attention to detail with Hot Toys figures, particularly not only in the fabrics, but also the wonderful color palette. Here, it looks really well, especially as it relates to the armor set. Just look at how intricate that looks, and you'll have to forgive me, I forgot to take off the foam padding. Nevertheless, that's just a testament to the quality of the packaging. This thing just looks really nice, guys, and again, everything is so striking, and it does look very realistic. The lower section of this piece is really nice, and I love mixed media, particularly when they use it well. Now here, the fabric again is very high quality. If you'll notice that silver buckle in the middle is actually integrated into the fabric, and I think it makes it look that much more organic. Again, the wonderful color palette here of the blues and those darker colors offset against the brown skin tones and earth tones, along with those yellow stripings, really make it stand out. Overall, guys, it just looks really nice, and you can tell this is Wakandan armor. Oftentimes, the biggest challenge for Hot Toys figures is getting the stance just right, because you do have to do it yourself, which has its drawbacks. Now, this is a process that has been refined by Hot Toys over the years, and I think they're really perfecting it now with their new ball joint system, and that's why the feet on this figure are very impressive. If you'll notice, because of that ball joint system, the feet lie a lot flush on whatever surface you're having it on, and it does look much more realistic in terms of the stance, so that's a really great thing. Now, one of the things you always have to contend with when you're dealing with a sleeveless figure or exposed skin is whether or not they used a full rubber body suit. Now, it has its pros and cons. The cons being, of course, that if you put it in extreme positions for a very long time, it has a tendency to crack. Now, here it's a little bit more high end. I also love the way that they hid the exposed joints, particularly where the wrists are. Overall, well done job, but just remember, guys, the more extreme poses, the more tendency it is to crack, so keep that in mind. Now, obviously for me, one of the coolest aspects of this figure is definitely in her spear, and they spared no expense in terms of the overall detail. It's really well done here. I love the finishes here with the silver, especially that kind of blue accent looks really nice. The staff itself, leading down all the way to the figure, is pretty lengthy and almost the entire length, which is really cool. Overall, it's very impressive. I really like what they did here. Now, it's up to you if you want to mirror this piece. There's not too much going on, but I will say if you don't mirror it, you're going to miss out on some really cool details on the reverse side, but mostly in the hair. I absolutely love the sculpt, but also just take a look at the markings and the etching on the reverse side where her scalp is exposed. That looks really cool, guys. Not too much fan service to think about here because it's exposed by the cloth. But again, this is a very unusual case where I would say it's up to you whether or not you want to mirror it. You also see the way that she attaches to the base, so it's up to you guys, but I'd say if you don't have a way to mirror this, it's not the end of the world. Now, for this figure, I'm really a fan of the waist grabber instead of the crotch grabber, mostly because I think it fits well with the character, and I don't know, it seems to me like you're gonna damage the figure less without it. The bass here is really nice, I have to admit. The finish is fantastic. I love the graphic. Obviously, it reads Black Panther, and it does say Shuri. This thing is just so nice, guys, and one of the more unique basses in this line. I absolutely love how intricate it is. I really hope they continue with the way that they did this for the rest of the line. Now, apart from the actual spear that you get and that we already mentioned in terms of weaponry, she also gets those two arm cannons that are really nice. These things are very well sculpted. I love the finish on them. There's a lot of carbon scarring there, and there's a nice wash to make them look very realistic. And they also light up, which is really cool. And one of the things that I really love about Hot Toys is that they go the extra mile just to have a little bit more detail and more movie accurate, which is really awesome, guys. And how do you light them up? Well, funny you should ask. Thankfully, Hot Toys always does the really right thing and includes the batteries, which is really cool. I don't see that they included a way to actually put them in, which is very unusual because they are very small, so getting them in and out can be kind of a pain in the ass. Nevertheless, we do have the actual batteries, so that's a cool thing. And rounding out the last bit of accessories are 5 additional hands for various poses. But again, guys, this is a full rubber body suit, so you don't want to go too crazy with the poses, just something to keep in mind. Nevertheless, it's cool that we have them, so you guys can get pretty intricate with the actual poses themselves. So yeah, guys, without question, this is an instant Holy Grail piece. She actually sold out very quickly. She's gone onto the secondary market and getting more and more expensive. So if you can find one for a relatively good price, definitely jump on it, guys, because it's getting a lot rarer and rarer as the years go on. It's going to go up in value, so definitely pick it up. Now, before I go, I just want to thank the folks over at Big Bad Toy Store for sending this wonderful piece over for review. And if you're interested in this and other collectibles, please visit www.bigbadtoystore.com. Alright everybody, so that's my official review on Hot Toys' version of Shuri, the 1/6 scale figure. As always, I thank you for tuning in, and I'll see you on the next AGR's Pop Culture Reviews. Wakanda Forever.